This is the application walkthrough for the Wyze Video Doorbell Pro. You can see if you have other Wyze products, they will be listed right here. And if we want to get into our video doorbell, we simply select it. Normally there would be a preview icon of the last thing that it took. However, I clear out those before I do videos. So let's get into it. Selecting our video doorbell brings us right in. We give that a moment to actually connect itself. And there we see 3 of 3, and we're brought right in. This is our video feed right here. I do have it for the circular cropped off, and we'll talk about that a little later as to why I did that. In the upper left-hand corner, you can see a percent for the battery. It is currently at 15% and marking red, letting you know, hey, you should probably bring this inside to charge, which I really like the fact that that's there. Right here, we can see our actual speed or data to the camera itself, giving you an idea of how stable your connection is, as well as the data feed that you will be getting. Right here, we have a big HD. Selecting that will allow us to change from HD to standard def. So again, if you need to save on your bandwidth, that's how you'd be able to do that. Coming down, we have our Cam Plus indicator right there, because you will need a Cam Plus subscription if you want package, pet, person, all that fun detection stuff. You have your date and time. And then if we double tap, we can zoom in and out. We can also pinch to zoom. So double tap will bring you slightly in. The pinch to zoom brings you in as far as you can go. And there we have a live feed of a camera going by, a car going by right there. One of my neighbors, tap, tap. You can see just how far over that goes, because that's my driveway, neighbor's driveway, and then the driveway next to that neighbor right there. Coming down to the bottom, we have our expand view. Doing that, kind of zooms it in, notice it takes up as much space as it can. We can zoom that back out. We have our audio on and off. I tend to keep that off just to kind of cut down on feedback when I'm doing my test. We have our mute. So if I turn that on, audio automatically turns on, and people outside are probably hearing me talk right now, but that's how you have a two-way conversation. Selecting mute turns them both off. We want more options. We simply select the three dots right here. This will allow us to take a still capture from our image right here. We can record what's going on right now. We can change what type of night mode we want. Do we want auto on all the time or off? And then right here, we have the option of changing our view. Notice, and it might be a little hard to see there, but it squares it off and then rounds it. Now, the reason I kept it on the slightly fisheye view here is because even if you have the squared view, your recordings are always going to look like this. So you might as well see exactly what you're getting at all times if the recordings are not going to mirror what's visible here. So food for thought. Selecting our options again, we have our quick responses. Selecting there.
Can I help you with something? Hey, I'll be at the door shortly. Hello, please leave the package by the door.
Notice there's no option for you to create your own personal away message. However, you do have these options. Then we do have access to our album if you wanted to get to your images. Now, again, the same thing I said about the Wyze Video Doorbell. If I'm going to do a quick response, opening this up, coming over here, then selecting quick responses, then selecting what I want it to say, doesn't really feel like a quick response to me, but it's nice that it's there. Down here, you actually have your timeline. So if you scrub right here, you can see that's indicating that there was a person. This is indicating that there was a person with a package. So if you let go on that, it will load up. There's male person coming in. We can pause that right there. We can enlarge, we can turn on the sound so we hear what's going on. We can play, we can download our clip right from here. And then we can either share or delete if we select our extra options button when we are here. So we're gonna bring that back to live, because that's really all the functionality of the camera and the camera settings that you can do here. However, we have more settings in the upper right-hand corner. Simply by selecting the sprocket icon, we're brought to the extra stuff that we can do. Starting at the top, we can rename the camera. I called it Video Doorbell Pro, just so I know what it was. Here we have our detection settings area. We have our motion detection sensitivity, low, medium to high. You can toggle that all the way up to 5 if you want. I have it on 4. That seems to do it for me and my particular situation. You can set up a detection zone, which I do have set up. And again, it uses the grid selection, which I've gotten used to and kind of like. So it makes it like maybe right there. I need that spot only in this to actually detect. So I can simply select it. Tapping it again will turn it off. You can clear, undo, or save. I am going to simply select cancel because I didn't change anything that I want to keep. We're going to come back one more time and we're going to come down to our event recordings. That big old plus there means that I have a subscription. Selecting this will bring me into the event recordings. Here we can see plus, we have the Cam Plus AI detection. Is pressed means is the doorbell pressed? Records motion event, does it detect motion? Here we have record cooldown. This is something I like that is new to Wyze Video Doorbell Pro. And that's the ability to choose how often you want the recording cooldown. I have it set for about a minute, but you can bring that no cooldown, meaning it'll just fire off all the time, and up to 5 minutes. We're gonna leave that at what I had. And then this is again, something new. Maximum video length. I have it set for 180, but you can have it down to as low as 15 seconds, which is kind of your standard Wyze normal video recording clip length. Well, actually it's 12 seconds, but I max at 180. I want to see everything. And then events will end early when motion stops, which it does, but I wish it kind of would look out a little further. We'll talk about that later. And then schedule enable will allow you to set days and times when all of this happens. If you don't, then it happens all the time, which is what I want. Next, we have notifications. Again, you have the plus letting you know, hey, there's some extra settings in here. So one, send notifications. Yes, I want to be notified when it picks up one of these events. I have the Wyze AI events, which are your persons, package, pets, etc. All other motion, I have turned off. Doorbell pressed, I have on. And then low battery warning, which it does do because it did that to me a couple of days ago. Here we have our advanced settings. Night vision, currently on auto, or on or off, obviously, on auto for me. Power saving mode, I turn that off. I want it on all the time. Use as much power as it needs. Battery percentage, you saw that on the front. Timestamp, watermark, also able to toggle that on and off. Wyze logo, on or off. Show bitrate, on or off. Record sound, on or off. And then sync, and then wide dynamic range, really helpful if you have a lot of bright light behind you. So again, there's a lot of customization that you can do here. And I like the fact that Wyze allows you to toggle on and off things that you don't necessarily think that you need. Coming down, we have Chime. This is going to, again, be the Chime box that you get. So it's Chime volume, Chime sound. We've got lots of different sounds that you can go through. Do not disturb mode. Again, a godsend if you have a significant other. Turning this on, well, as you can see, turn on do not disturb mode, Chime won't ring, and it will push the notification to your phone. Period, turning that on will let you select from when to when. So if you have something every day during a specific time frame, you can set that right there. I do not because I want that ringing all the time, but the fact that you have the ability to do that with Wyze is one of the things that separates them from other smart video doorbells out there. Coming down, we have our accessories. Well, the accessory that we don't currently have any extra accessories, but if we wanted to, we click the plus sign right up here, which will allow us to walk through setting something up. You have your rules right there. Sharing, again, you can share your camera. If you have somebody who has their own Wyze account, simply share. Device info, as you might imagine, lots of sensitive information, so we're not gonna touch on that. And then Wyze support, nice that it's there, but wish their case management was a little better. And those were all of our settings for the Wyze Video Doorbell Pro. We are going to come back to our main page and quickly touch on the icons at the bottom. We have home, we have events, which will show us all of the events, which we can filter for person, package, which particular camera we want. That's all done right through here. And then you can even select or which camera. You have monitoring if you have any of their monitoring services. You have your shop tab right there. And then last but not least is our account, which will allow us to access our services. Selecting our services, here we have our Video Doorbell Pro has our current Cam Plus license. Selecting this will allow us to change it if we wanted to. And that is everything that you can do with the Wyze app for the Wyze Video Doorbell Pro.